Hello everyone. This video is about the poem The Earthen Goblet. It is written by Harindranath Chattopadhyay. This poem is written as a dialogue between the poet and the goblet. Before I start the video, I request all of you to subscribe my channel and also hit the bell icon, because whenever I upload a new video, you will get a notification. Harindranath Chattopadhyay was born on 2nd April 1898 in Hyderabad in a Bengali Hindu Kulin Brahmin family to Agoranath Chattopadhyay and Bharata Sundari Devi. He was a multi-talented personality as an Indian English poet. English poet, a dramatist, an actor, a musician and a member of 1st Lok Sabha from Vijayawada constituency. He was the younger brother of Sarojini Nayudu, the first woman president of Indian National Congress. He is famous for poems like Noon and Shape or Shape. Let us try to analyze the poem and try to understand its meaning. Let me read the first stanza for you all. O silent goblet, red from head to heel, how did you feel when you were being twirled upon the potter's wheel before the potter gave you to the world? In the first stanza, the poet asked the goblet, which was red from head to heel, about its feeling when it was being twirled upon the potter's wheel. I felt a conscious impulse in my clay to break away from the great potter's hand that burned so warm. I felt a vast feeling of sorrow to be cast into my present form. In the second stanza, we can see the goblet replying that it felt sad to be in its present form. It wanted to break away from the potter's hand who burnt it warm. It also felt sorrow to be molded into its present form. Before that fatal hour that saw me captive on the potter's wheel and cast into his crimson goblet sleep, I used to feel the fragrant friendship of a little flower whose root was in my bosom buried deep. In the third stanza, the goblet further explains that before the fatal hour, it was a prisoner on the potter's wheel. The potter has molded it into the crimson-colored goblet. Before it was cast into the goblet form, it used to feel the fragrant and pleasant friendship of a little flower. The root of the flower was buried deep in its bosom. The potter has drawn out of the living breath of me and given me a form which is the death of me. My past unshapely natural state was best with just one flower flaming through my breast. In the fourth and the last stanza, the goblet very pathetically tells that the potter has drawn out the living breath of it. It gave it a form which was its death. Further, the earthen goblet very sorrowfully tells that its past form as a clay was the best because it used to have the company of one little flower flaming through its breast. Now let us learn the poetic devices used in the poem. First one is rhyme. Words that rhyme have the same last sound. Here are some of the words taken from the poem. Heel, feel. Twirled, world. Vast, cast. Sleep, deep. Our, flower. Second one, alliteration. The repetition of consonants at the beginning of two or more words. Example, fragrant friendship, bosom buried. Personification. The act of giving a human quality or characteristic to something which is not human. Example, O silent goblet. I felt a conscious impulse in my clay. Metaphor. An expression that describes a person or object by referring to something that is considered to possess similar characteristics. Example, goblet sleep. I hope you have all understood the poem The Earthen Goblet. Now here is an activity for you all. Write a conversation between the poet and the earthen goblet. Do like, share and subscribe my channel and also hit the bell icon, because whenever I upload a new video, you will get a notification. All my previous videos links are given in the description box. You can click on the links and watch my videos. Thank you.